Well, I was going to leave it, but I decided to clean it up. Get it back to where it was when the man made it. And I discovered a leak underneath all the solder. And I used a solder sucker to remove all the newer solder on this. And there was a crack in the bend right here. So I had to sand down to finish the patina here, which unfortunately I had to do. But there was a crack here, so I put a little piece of solder on top of the crack after putting down some flux. And it sealed up immediately, filled the crack. Didn't melt the original solder. Still has a bit of the knurling on it from the twist. And it screws into the shell, which is really nice. So we actually took the time to thread it. Probably adapted most of these parts from other steam engines, I think. German in nature. And I just realized that the meter here... Anyways, the meter here is kilograms per meter, I think. So, I'm not sure the equivalency, so I'm going to be really careful and not take it above 2, which is the maximum I've taken it to. Which I've, running the Cirrus, I think it is about 30 PSI. And it's nice that this is leaking a little bit of water just so that it doesn't get too out of hand too quickly. And that will pop, so I'll show you that right now with my weights on the end here. Very interesting thing here. On the weight that came in the box, there's a meat token I put on there from World War II. But definitely a 1916 shell. It has the 1916 on it. It has US on it, meaning US produced. It has a whole bunch of markings that I'm not familiar with. It doesn't look like it was reloaded, but it only has one F after the C. And if there's two Fs, then you know it's been reloaded. But it does have lot number and everything else on it, which I'm not too sure the details of. And my repair is holding. We are at 2 kilograms per square something, centimeter perhaps. I'm not sure. Looks like square centimeters. So, but we'll let it boil away here and see how much pressure we build up. We've got two burners going. We've got one of the two of the large Falk burners going to test that and make sure it's working still. Both of them produce quite a bit of flame, so it licks up the sides of this a bit too much. The wheels are working out well. I've just pushed this back right now so that I can adjust and work on this and unscrew the actual manometer. The whistle works great. Very loud. And the steam is very dry. No drips. No drips at all. And it's about half full right now. So that's quite a lot of water in there. It's about 2 liters, I would say. Well, we're approaching our record level, 2.1 kilograms per centimeter. And there's 2.5 centimeters per inch. So, and there's 2.3 kilograms per, 2.3 pounds per kilogram. So, 2.3 pounds per kilogram. And then times 2.5. So one is about 6 or 7 pounds per square inch, I think, but I think it's way further beyond 14 PSI right now, if you look at the... And I do trust it, because it's an explosive device, so a shell is quite a sound piece of boiler material. And I actually might grab an 18-pounder, they're not too expensive, and make one myself. And perhaps build a traction engine, because it would make a great traction engine, RC, if you had a shell, an artillery shell as a boiler, and the engine mounted somewhere. almost 2.5 now, and we're going to call it quits at 2.5 because we're only testing our repair here, and our repair has worked great. It looks a lot cleaner now. It is as the maker intended, plus a Viton O-ring, which is acting as the seal. Didn't have to seal that. This valve is shot, pretty much. Leaks quite a bit, but no water, because it is in the steam dome. Steam dome solder points are all excellent and tight, no leaks. Very little places, or very few places where solder could be melted away by the burn, other than the steam dome, because the cap is so far away from the flame. The filler cap is awesome, great centimeter diameter, very easy to fill this. And we are at 2.3, and go to 2.5 and call it quits. Makes quite a nice noise at this pressure. Sure, it would start whistling eventually if it were to go too high. You could actually adjust this so that you would have a warning. And now it would become higher as pressure built. The whistle would make more noise. It's pumping away. Almost at 2.5 now. My solder joint is holding. No leaks on the back end, which is really the presentation end of this. That's why I wanted to clean up all that nasty solder that was on there, because it is the whole indicator of where this came from. The lower plug, I'm not too sure about. I'm not sure why that is there. Maybe there was a sight glass before he got a pressure gauge, because there is no sight glass on this boiler. Making all kinds of noises now. Close the whistle off. Put a little hook on the front here. When I get the front mounting done, then be able to have like a hook on there as it's been towed around or something. Though the wheels don't move on this. It is stationary, so it won't start rolling away. I'm going to remachine the Stewart number 1 crankshaft this week. I've got a live center now, so I'm going to be working on that. So that should be up and running, and perhaps we'll run it off this boiler and see how long we can keep it running for, because this boiler seems to be quite reliable. Perhaps a veteran made it, and it's very practical. Definitely made to be used. This wasn't a shelf display or something like that, so... Well, we've jumped way almost up to 2.75 or 3, so we're going to shut it down at this point, blow out the flame, because I think that's a lot of pressure. When your lever's bleeding and your pressure releases right on the balance, hate to waste all this steam. Great little steam boiler. And we'll let out the steam. Amazing that manometer still works after all these years. Judging by the patina, I would say it's at least 80 or 90 years old. Fittings especially. All 20th century. Well, we'll get it hooked up to an engine and make a video now that I've fixed that leak. Feels good to improve something. Have a good day, guys. See ya.